galaxies, clouds, nebulae, eyes, the nervous system, mountains, rivers, broccoli, trees, lightning, lungs, veins, and leaves, what do they all have in common? Well, you may notice it's all about patterns, right? So what is going on? Why nature chooses these patterns over and over on such a different scale? And why there is such similarities that took place in the universe? To understand is to perceive patterns, the philosopher Isaiah Berlin said. That's how we extract meaning, connect the dots, trying to make sense of the noise. Because we are the conscious agents of nature, and we have the potential to see the world in a grain of sand, to see heaven in a wide flower, to hold infinity in the palm of our hand, and hold eternity in an hour, as expressed by Jason Silva. We humans like patterns. It's a place of wonder between art and science. There is some connection between fractals and the way nature operates. Fractals are self-replicating yet unique structure. It will continue to create infinitely repeated patterns from the original shape. And that's what we call a self-similarity, or a similarity of scale. More profoundly, not necessarily self-similar, although there are fractals that aren't symmetric, so we called it a quasi-self-similar. What you're seeing now is an infinite geometrical visualization of a fractal. And yes, when I say infinite, I really mean that. This is infinity embodied in front of you in an elegant, aesthetic, beautiful way. And if you continue looking closer and zooming in, it will surprise you with more details and new areas. A friend of mine called it a theoretical infinite plane of art. This is Mandelbrot's set, the eye of the universe. And guess what you would never expect? All this beauty can be derived from a simple mathematical equation, which even a high school student can handle. The beginning was in 1980 at IBM. A genius mathematician called Benoit Mandelbrot ignited all this geometrical revolution. Mandelbrot was a Polish-born French-American with interest in the practical sciences, especially regarding what he labeled as the art of roughness. He is recognized from his contribution to the field of fractal geometry, which include coining the word fractal, as well as developing a theory of roughness and self-similarity in nature.
Well, it's very interesting. If you cut with a sharp knife one of the florets of a cauliflower and look at it separately, you think the whole cauliflower, but smaller. And then you cut again, and you still get smaller cauliflowers. So the experience of humanity has always been that there are some shapes which have this peculiar property that each part is like the whole, but smaller. Now, what did humanity do with that? Very, very little. So, what I did actually is to study this problem.
Since he was a boy, Mandelbrot had always thought visually. In 1958, he began a 35-year career at IBM, where he became an IBM fellow. Because of his access to IBM's computers, Mandelbrot was one of the first to use computer graphics to create and display fractal geometric images, leading to his discovery of Mandelbrot's set in 1980. He showed how visual complexity can be created from simple rules. He said that things typically considered to be rough, a mess, or chaotic, such as a cloud, actually had the degree of order. At the time, IBM was involved in transmitting computer data over phone lines, but a kind of white noise kept disturbing the flow of information, breaking the signal. IBM looked to Mandelbrot to provide a new perspective on the problem, when the mathematicians around the world revolved around the simplest of equations, z equals z squared plus c. Mandelbrot used high-powered computers to iterate the equation. With these computers, Mandelbrot crunched and manipulated the numbers 1,000 times over, 1,000,000 times over, and graphed the outputs. The result was an awkwardly shaped bug-like formation, but as Mandelbrot looked closer, he saw the details. What's more, every smaller version held more complex detail than the previous version. These structures were not exactly alike, but the general shape was similar. This was a new kind of geometry previously unknown by the scientific community. So taming this monster became possible due to modern computers. Mandelbrot knew he was onto something. and quickly published his finishings. This shape and structure, later known as the Mandelbrot set, was an extraordinary, complex and beautiful example of a fractal object. And this is how the first fractal has born, discovered, created, who knows. I stumble up with an amazing idea that says the universe itself that we live in is a fractal building. And if you zoomed in between the discovered galaxies, you will find inside the trillions of stars and solar systems that contain the planets and maybe an Earth. On it, you will find continents and cities and buildings and the human. And inside the human, you will find the brain made of millions of cells forming a giant network of neurons similar to the galactic network. And inside the neuron, you will find the DNA. And that DNA is made from atoms and electrons, protons, neutrons, quarks and subatomic particles and so on, and then maybe continuously deeper into infinity. But you can argue that perfect fractals repeat infinitely and are only found in the abstract world of mathematics. Nonetheless, the physical world we live in contains proximate fractals that go so many steps and then eventually they break. In the universe, you can't do that forever, zooming in without a breakdown into atoms, and atoms aren't fractals. But we can make fractals from atoms. Even on the molecular level, researchers have been able to make and see a fractal pattern out of electrons, specifically a Sierpinski triangle, and with really exciting results. And some go further and say some philosophical cool stuff like our world is a fractal run by a computer simulation by analogy to the law that govern the universe, and same as an equation that governs the fractal. And if we figured out that law, well, which lead to an obvious conclusion, God is a mathematician, and the universe is an unperfect model of an ideal fractal. Ancient civilization have also noticed the aesthetic side of fractals, and that can be found in many work of art like the giant wave. Fractal art is found in ancient Indian architecture. Many Southeast Asian temples and monuments exhibit attractive structures. They are also prevalent in Arabic architecture and Western cathedrals. Today, fractal geometry is applied in many various fields such as science, engineering, art, design, music, and economy. In some other applications in weather and climate, biology and medicine, telecommunication, architecture, and the greatest use of fractals is yet to be discovered. I think fluid mechanics and turbulent fluid flow simulations may be also a field where fractal geometry can be applied. Fractal approximations can help model the flow of fluids for application in aerodynamics, CFD, computational fluid dynamics, and many complex engineering problems. And here's a couple of images generated on Bing AI art tool, Image Creator, when I asked it to create an image of water flow and turbulence using fractal style. Dr. Eugene Wigner, who is a PhD physicist, Nobel Prize winner, brilliant man, wrote a wonderful article years ago called The Unreasonable Effectiveness of Mathematics and Natural Sciences from a Secular Perspective. And he said, it's unreasonable that mathematics should work so wonderfully in explaining the physical universe, since the mathematics is abstract and the universe is physical, and the universe obeys mathematical laws. Also, he added, it is difficult to avoid the impression that a miracle comforts us here. Or the two miracles, the existence of laws of nature and the human mind's capacity to divine them. It is amazing that we are here to appreciate the beauty. And at the end of our journey, I'm not selling anything here, and I am mostly in this for subs and likes, so please do be sure to do one of each before you go today. Thank you for watching, and don't stop wondering. I leave you with that. Peace.
Well, let me finish. This shape here just came out of an exercise in pure mathematics. Bottomless wonders spring from simple rules which are repeated without end. Thank you very much.